In this video, I'll be using the Samsung Galaxy Watch and the Samsung Health Monitor app to measure these three things. However, even if you own any other brand, just continue watching the video because most brands use the same sort of functions and navigations. So it will give you an idea of how to go about measuring the blood pressure ECG as well as looking at your heart rate using your own watch. Now, for the blood pressure, initially you have to calibrate the watch. What that means is you would have to use your blood pressure cuff that you normally use for taking your blood pressure and take three readings, having the watch on your wrist so that the watch is also measuring your blood pressure while your blood pressure monitor is also measuring your blood pressure. Whatever reading you get using your blood pressure monitor, that reading you have to enter into the Samsung Health Monitor app. You have to do this three times, and once you do that, the watch will give you a message saying it's been calibrated. This calibration lasts for 28 days, so then simply you can use the watch only to take your blood pressure reading. For ECG, there's no such fuss. All you have to do is use your watch and click on the record button and it will record your ECG, and that will come up in the Samsung Health Monitor app. So please hit the subscribe button now and let's get started.
To measure the blood pressure as well as the ECG, you have to move to the respective screens. So here I'm just scrolling through my smartwatch to get to the first screen, which is the blood pressure screen. So this is the screen that is used to monitor your blood pressure. Now what it's saying here is that your watch calibration has expired and learn more. So now here it's asking me, allow Samsung monitor to access your sensor data about your vital signs. I'll click on allow. It says your watch calibration has expired. Follow the instruction, and then I'll open these instructions on my phone. So I'm just going to click here, and you can see that the Samsung Health Monitor app has opened up on my phone. So what it's saying here is that your watch calibration has expired and to follow the instructions to recalibrate your watch. I'll have to first recalibrate the watch, and then we can use this watch to take the blood pressure. So when I click on open the phone on the app, it opens up the Samsung Health Monitor app on the phone. I have put my watch in exactly as they have instructed. It says the wrist orientation is set to left. Make sure the watch is snug on your wrist.
So then I have to fit the medical blood pressure monitor cuff to the arm. So I'm going to do that and then start the blood pressure monitor.
So here it says your watch will start measuring automatically. Has started measuring. So it's now finished measuring my blood pressure. It says enter the reading from the blood pressure monitor on the phone.
So on the phone it says, is there a blood pressure monitor reading? And if I say yes, then enter the blood pressure reading from your blood pressure monitor. So I will enter the reading that came up on my monitor. Systolic and diastolic blood pressure, and then confirm the reading. So now I have completed one of the three measurements. So I have to keep the watch and the cuff on, follow the instructions on the next screens to continue with the calibration process.
So now I'm taking my second reading. It says your watch will start measuring automatically. And I've started my blood pressure monitor, and yeah, there it started measuring my blood pressure for a second time. And again, it's done now, the second reading. So it says enter the reading from the blood pressure monitor on the phone. So I'm going to now enter my second. So now it's saying two of the three measurements have been completed. Keep the watch as well as the cuff on, and then take the last measurement. So now I'm taking the last measurement. So here what the watch actually does is it gets a feel of your blood pressure, and then it matches that with what your blood pressure monitor says. So it's completed my third reading, and now I'm going to enter that blood pressure on my phone. So now that I've taken all the three readings, the watch says now you can take a blood pressure measurement using your watch because you've finished calibrating it, and it's brought up exactly the same message on the phone as well saying that your calibration is finished. So now the watch has started measuring my blood pressure. So it has brought up my blood pressure as 133 by 83 today, and my heart rate as 85 beats per minute, and it says do not change your medication or your dosage. And it's brought up the same thing on the phone. In order to take your ECG, the watch does not ask for a prior calibration. All I have to do is to click on this record button on the ECG screen. So here it says rest the finger lightly on the home key and make sure your watch is snug on your left wrist. Wear the watch 10 minutes before recording the ECG. Moisturize your skin and try again. That's because I didn't put the finger in, so
I click on the record button to record the ECG and then click OK. You have to rest your finger lightly on the home key to record your ECG. And now the watch has started recording. It's asked me to stay still and keep the finger on the key. So it started taking the recording again right from the beginning, probably because I was not still, my hand may not be still. So there, I moved again, so it's again started taking the ECG right from the beginning, so starting from the 30 second and counting down. So to record the ECG, you have to make sure that your hand remains really still and that the finger that you rest on the home key is not dry and should be well moisturized. The watch has finished recording the ECG and it gives you the result. Here it says no signs of arterial fibrillation. It also shows the average heart rate. You can add any symptoms there in case you're feeling unwell, and then click on done. So you can take a second ECG if you want, again the same way by keeping your finger on the home key, and then it starts recording your second ECG.
Now these recordings will be stored in the Samsung Health Monitor app, and we'll come to that soon in the video to see where these recordings are stored in the app. So I've completed the second ECG recording. Make sure you click on the done button so that this recording gets stored on the app. I don't want to take any more recordings, so I go to the home screen.
So now that I have taken my ECG recording, if I come back to the Samsung Health Monitor app and I click on the ECG recording, it shows that for today it has taken my ECG recording, and it also shows my heart rate as 100 beats per minute at that time with no symptoms. And if I want, I can share this report. If I want, I can click on share this report to share it on or send it using applications such as WhatsApp or email or Messenger. I look at view history. That's my history. So see, I had taken two readings. So in the previous screen, it just shows your latest reading. But if you go into history, it will show you all the readings. So I had taken two readings, one after the other, and therefore it's showing me two readings that it had taken. And then you can just click on any one of them to get a more detailed chart, as well as more details like what was your heart rate, etc., any symptoms that you might have recorded. You can also share this report. So that's how you measure your blood pressure and your ECG using the Samsung Health Monitor app.
So friends, hope you enjoyed watching this video. Let me know in the comments below, how would you measure your blood pressure and ECG? Would you still use your watch, or would you go to your doctor, or would you use your normal medical cuff at home and measure your blood pressure? I look forward to reading your comments. See you soon in the next video.